What's up guys, NaxTech here, and this is going to be a tutorial on how to flash a custom kernel to the Nexus 10. So I haven't done anything yet, I haven't even downloaded the file, but obviously you will need to be rooted and unlocked bootloader. If you don't know how to do that, check out my video on how to root the Nexus 10. So yeah, let's get into it. Firstly, I need to download the kernel. So if I go into Tapatalk here and click XDA Developers, we can go over to Nexus 10 Android Development. And the one I've been looking at is this one, the KT Manta kernel. So this is the one I'm going to flash. So let's dive in here. And, you know, all kernels are different. You know, they've all got the different features. You can read them all here. This is an overclocking kernel. It's got optimizations. It's got different governors and all that cool stuff. So we need to download the zip. So here's the zip. We'll open it with Dolphin. Hopefully it should just give us a download link and we can move on. Here we go. Download link's going to go into the download folder. I'm also going to download the kernel tweaker app here, which is actually the developer's app, which you can control what the kernel does. So might as well get that as well. And that's it. Let's just wait for these to download. They're both downloaded. So what I'm going to do now is turn off the tablet. And we need to get into recovery mode and get into the custom recovery that we installed when we rooted the device. So to do that, you need to hold, well, when it turns off, you need to hold all three buttons. And you'll hear a buzz, and there you go. And the volume rockers left and right, you'll see it change here to recovery. Recovery mode, we'll hit the power button to enter. And now it should, there we go, load up into our custom recovery. Now, whenever you do anything with the kernel or ROMs, make sure you do a backup. It's very simple. You just press backup and slide this across. I'm not going to do it because I've actually already done that. So yeah, because it's quite long. So all you have to do now, guys, is install, pick your where you downloaded it to. So it was downloads and it's this one here. This is it. So you can see here it gives you some warnings. File to flash and confirm to flash, and you just swipe. Boom. And there you go. It says successful. Now, whenever you do stuff with the kernel, really, you should wipe the cache. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. And there is some other stuff you need to do. You also need to fix permissions. This just helps everything run the way it should. We'll quickly press back and let's see if there's anything else we need to do. Is there anything else we need to do? Don't think there is. You may have wiped both these, but I think I already did that in that one button. So yeah, that's basically it, guys. So we're going to reboot now. Reboot the system. And here we go. Now it should boot back up. Hopefully no boot loops, but we should have a custom kernel running now. Obviously, if you want to go back to your complete stock, you just restore through the backup that you should have done. And it's always clever to do a backup because in case something goes wrong, you know, you can just restore. And being a Nexus device, it's pretty damn hard to actually software brick these devices because of the fact it's Nexus. So yeah, you can see here, Android is upgrading. And there we go, guys. It started up and obviously it looks exactly the same. But if we go into the settings, hit about tablet, and if you see the kernel version here is that custom kernel. Hopefully you can see that. Now, I'm not going to go through what the kernel does. I'm going to do that in a different video, but that's pretty much and how easy it is to flash a custom kernel on the Nexus 10. So yeah, guys, I'll see you later.